I used to believe that if I want to be good at any skill, I should practice that skill every day. So if I'm not practicing a particular skill every day, I won't be good at that particular skill. So when I started my business 5 years ago, every day in the morning for 7 to 10 hours, I used to take classes because I was teaching students on GMAT. After that, I used to work on marketing for 2 to 3 hours. And after that, at the end of the day, I used to make sales calls. So I want to be good at all the three skills. I want to be good at teaching GMAT. I want to be good at marketing. And I want to be good at sales as well, all at the same time. So for initial 1 to 2 years of starting my business, I followed this schedule. But at the end of every day, there was a sense of unsatisfaction. Because I used to think that I can do better than what I'm doing. But the problem is that in the morning, I used to teach for 7 to 8 hours. So I used to get tired both mentally and physically. But my belief was that I have to do everything every day. So with that tired mind, I used to do marketing. And at the end of the day, I used to do sales call. But when you're learning something, because I was trying to learn marketing, I was learning sales. Because my mind was tired, my mind was not ready to focus on that particular skill. So for the sake of doing it, I was doing it. So for almost 2 years, my business did not grow at the rate I expected. So slowly I realized that if I focus on quantity, I won't be able to give quality. But again, that was my fear, because I feared that if I do less, it will be impacting my sales or revenues, because there was a consistent fear, because I have to generate revenues every day. So every day I was doing what all is possible. So my main focus was on quantity. I was not focusing on quality, though I know that quality was important than quantity. So after 2 years, I did a small change. So during the week, I invested one complete day on marketing and sales, and remaining 6 days on teaching. Earlier, I used to think that if I did this by dividing the days based on the activities, I would lose on quantity. But slowly I realized that when I just give one day to marketing, I could produce better quality content. I can do better in marketing as well as in sales. And slowly I even realized that I'm getting better in teaching as well. Because when I'm teaching, I'm just teaching. I'm not bothered about marketing or sales. So when we just focus on one thing at a stretch, we can easily get better quality and more quantity. This is something I normally tell my students also, because most of my students are working professionals. So they think or they believe that they have to study for GMAT every day. So what they do in the morning, they go to work, they work for 10 to 12 hours, then they come home and then they study. But when they study at night, the mind is already tired. Even physically, they are tired. So they have the books in front of them, but they're not able to focus. They're getting irritated. So they're investing time, but they're not getting the results. And this creates irritation and even the fear, because you're putting in effort, you think that you're not able to understand things. So rather than studying every day, you can divide your week in different parts. So for 5 days, you can focus on your work. Don't bother about GMAT. And on the weekends, you can go completely into GMAT. You may think that no, you have to study every day, otherwise you will forget. No, it will not happen. There are few things, if you understand things, you will not forget. So next time when you're planning, you're scheduling your studies for GMAT, so make sure that you focus on keeping your study days and your work days separate. Don't try to mix them. I hope this helps you to improve your GMAT score. Thank you.